but you notice it's how to minister to sexual issues.
Only 16% of Christians, born-again Christians, professing Christians, actually have their values based on the Bible.
What does the Bible actually say, and how does science corroborate that? It's going to cover the science of love. It's going to cover lust and pornography, and how both clean love and how lust and pornography affect your brain and actually form brain traps in your own mind. What gives the enemy legal ground to become a hitchhiker in your life?
We are in a culture that presses us to bow to that. You know, if you do say what you believe, you're bigoted, you're narrow-minded, and you're unloving. If you don't say what you believe, you're walked all over, and you're taken to agree with the culture that is trying to change us.
We will teach you how to discern in your own life what's clean and unclean.
If you ever wanted to see culture, it hasn't changed. It wants us to conform. And it's been that way all through Bible times. And if you really want to get a good study in, you want to read the story of Daniel and how he decided to stand for what he believed in during his Babylonian experience. It is one of the most prevalent issues. Sexual issues are the top dog in the church, not just outside. It's in the church.
Whatever has been learned can be unlearned.
God will give you the tools to show you how you can check yourself out. There's no greater experience for me than to see someone caught up in sexual sin, freed up, and feeling clean inside.
We should be the most educated, most prepared people in the world, Christians, because it is so necessary in our culture.